Now, our next speaker, ladies and gentlemen, he's a guru when it comes to leveraging your direct sales business through social media. Anybody on social media out there? Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, you name it. It's social media. He has mastered this new and exciting avenue for promoting your business and is here to share with us how you can increase your business through these amazing sites. Please welcome to the stage, Matthew Murchie. Here he is.
How's everyone doing? Feeling nice and relaxed? A nice little break? Ready to learn a little bit about? Had dinner with those two lovely ladies back there. So you ready to learn a little bit about social media today? Yeah? All right, do we have the clicker here? Sorry, the clicker back there? Perfect, no worries. All right, so today what we're gonna be talking a little bit about is social media and how to use it in your business. We all know that, thank you, is very important. I mean, it's everywhere. So we're gonna talk today about social media. A little bit about myself. I've been involved in social media for about 12 years now. So I know a few things about it. I'm also SEO Pro certified, which is just an acronym for search engine optimization. Fancy way of saying I know how to get websites ranked on Google. More importantly, I am a DSA member and have been for a number of years. I've been involved in the industry for a number of years. Actually, it's part of my company's name, DSOL Media, where I'm the director of possibilities there. DSOL, just for anybody who's curious, stands for Direct Selling Online. And I am the trainer, speaker, and director of success at social media training for directselling.com. So enough of the formalities, let's go over what we're gonna cover today. Social Media Revolution 2015 is a video done by a gentleman by the name of Eric Qualman, who is a brilliant social media strategist and fantastic when it comes to videos. He has some amazing statistics. I'm pretty sure a lot of you are gonna get your minds blown by what he shows in this video here. Right after that, we're gonna go and play a little bit of a game. On your tables, you'll see a handout. I want you to get those handouts ready shortly after the video because we will be using them. We're going to be doing a little bit of a word association. In particular, we're going to be focusing on Facebook. All right? So all the words that are in that word association have to do with Facebook. After that, because I've consulted with a lot of companies and their consultants, IBOs and reps, I've learned a few things that people do typically as mistakes. And of course, I understand that, you know, we're not always taught how to do things. And that's what I'm really hoping to achieve here in today's presentation. So I'm going to tell you a little bit of the mistakes that I see happen and how we need to change our mindset to make sure that we are getting the best bang for our buck for every post that we do. Right after that, we're going to follow that with what does work on Facebook. This is the exact process my team uses to get the best engagement, likes, shares on Facebook. I'll show you our complete start to finish process. We actually do manage the Direct Selling Association social media marketing efforts, and the process I show you is the exact process we use. It works really well. If we have time, because I will be spending a little bit of time on that, if we do have time, I have some bonus content for you, all right? And I have something truly amazing at the very end of the presentation, a little gift. I shouldn't say it's a little gift, it's a huge gift from Nature Sunshine that they've given you. Nature Sunshine is truly an incredible company. They're incredibly generous, and it's a big one. I'm gonna surprise you at the end. So let's get started with the Social Media Revolution video. Oops.
Thank you.
Pretty cool stuff, huh? Interesting statistics. More people own a mobile device than a toothbrush. I don't know if that's good or bad. Anyhow, if that didn't convince you that social media is an imperative part of your business, these next few slides probably will. Over 30% of people that end up on a site came from a social media site originally. The highest being Facebook, and hence why we're going to be concentrating this presentation on Facebook. Still not convinced? Here's the age and gender breakdown of social networks. Anywhere from millennial women to millennial men, all the way up to the baby boomers, and for men and women, are all on Facebook. And here's just the benefits of social media, why people use social media. It generated exposure for my business, 88% agreed. 72 increased traffic to a site, 62 improved search engine rankings, 56 resulted in new business partnerships, 51 generated qualified leads, 49% reduced overall marketing expense, hey, that's good, 43% improved sales. Now, I've actually seen that last one, that 43% improved sales, actually a little bit higher for everyone here, just because we're a little bit more personal with our customers. We're not just a typical retail store where we say, hi, thanks for the sale, and you know, maybe we'll see you a little bit later on. We have a little bit more of a personal engagement with them, so they keep coming back. So improved sales tend to be a little bit higher. So time to do a little game. Word association. On your tables, there are pieces of paper. Look for the word association game where words are on the left, definitions are on the right. We've all played a variation of this game where we try to match up the words to the proper definitions. No, the definitions are not in the same order. They're all mixed up. So we're gonna spend about 2 to 3 minutes to try to match up the right words with the right definitions. I wanna make sure that everybody understands the lingo of Facebook before we continue onwards. All right, so I'll give you 2 to 3 minutes to do this. Grab out a pen and pencil, and we'll go over it right after. Feel free to also mingle between yourselves if you don't really understand something. It's not a race or anything. I just want to make sure that everybody understands the jargon of Facebook. Thank you. I need one of those. So I need one of those. Those are awesome. Hands up if you're more or less done. A few of us, okay. A couple more, about another minute or so. All right, I think that's about enough time now. Let's go over all the definitions right now. Avatar, image or username that represents a person online. A group is a community of people built around a specific topic or interest. Hashtag is used to show that a message is related to an event or category. Chat, form of real-time text-based communication between two or more people. Oh, sorry, my apologies. I'll give you a couple seconds here just to kind of catch up. I apologize if I'm going a little too fast, trying to fit everything in to the hour. We got a lot to cover. All right, a like. A quick way to show approval, preference, and share the message. A meme. Typically an image with text above and below it, but it can also come in a video used to describe a thought, idea, or a joke. Now you probably see, if you're on Facebook, you probably saw a lot of memes come out recently about the Baptista bat flip. That's a meme. Oh, did everyone get that before we go on to the next page? Everyone okay? Hands up if you just need a couple of seconds just to review it. Okay, I see a couple of hands up. Not a problem. We good? Yeah, okay. Let's go on to the next few. Newsfeed or timeline, homepage of users' accounts where they can see all the latest updates from their friends. A page. This is a business presence on Facebook, otherwise known as a Facebook business page. Profile, a personal account on Facebook. Now I want you to star these two, page and personal, simply because we're gonna be talking about this in a couple of minutes. There is a big difference between the two. Tagging, likes a person, page, or place to something you post, like a video or photo. Last but not least, insights. Another one I want you to star, because we're going to be talking about this in just a few minutes. This is an area where analytical data will be displayed to show you the performance of your page. This is where Facebook will tell you how often people are visiting your business page, how old they are. Are they male, female? Where did they come from? A lot of great data comes from Facebook Insights. I'll just give you a couple more seconds to kind of make sure that you have all the proper words and definitions. Hands up if you need just a couple more minutes. Oh, good. Everyone's done. Perfect. All right. Let's move on to some of the mistakes and mindsets that I've seen happen over the last little while and how we need to change the way we think when we post things on Facebook. First biggest mistake I've seen is people not posting enough pictures or video on the Facebook business pages. We habitually type up our status updates and our post updates, and it gets repetitive. People don't always want to read. They like to see things too. After all, picture says 1,000 words and videos say a lot more. The other mistake I see happen is too many one-way conversations. Now, this is probably due to the fact that a lot of people just post text-based updates. So, MJ, you and I were chatting yesterday over dinner, and we had a great conversation. If that conversation went a little differently, where I did all the talking to you, back and forth, I was telling you, I'm having a great time at conference, having a blast, love the energy here, and I stopped it right there. A little bit awkward, isn't it? Because you don't really, how do you respond to that? You can't. You wouldn't do that in real life, because that just really makes an awkward situation. Well, translate that into social media. What do people do then? Simple, they just skim right past your post, go to the next one. All right? Instead, we need to change that mindset. To start off where I finished off with MJ, if I said, I'm having a great time, love the energy, just out of curiosity, MJ, what was your favorite part about conference? Love to know. I'll give you that $20 later on, okay? But that's what we miss on Facebook. We don't encourage engagement. We don't end things with a question. We just say something and that's it. We need to encourage engagement so that people like it, share it, and comment. The biggest problem that I see, 90% of the conversations, 90% of the posts that happen on a business page is about that person. Think about that. If 90% of the time I was talking to MJ over dinner and everything I was saying was about me and how wonderful I am and all the stuff I have to sell and what I do, she'd get bored. She'd just move on to a different table, right? So we need to change that mindset. 90% of the time, it should not be about you. It should be about everything else happening in your industry, all right? If that happens, 10% of the time, you can start posting stuff about you and what you offer. Now I'm gonna show you how to solve that problem, because that is the biggest problem. In our process that we'll show you in just a couple of minutes, we solve that problem very quickly. The best analogy I can give you when you're on Facebook and you're starting to post something and you're gonna question yourself going, should I do it or should I not? Use the first date analogy. If you're on a first date, and I'm sure we've all been there, if that other person on the other side starts talking a lot about themselves, you're probably not gonna give them a second date. Instead, you want them to start asking things about you, and you wanna start asking things about them. We need to start doing that on social media. After all, it's in the name, social media. So we need to start creating that communication back and forth. One of the other biggest things that happen on Facebook, now this is not a big thing because I say it's a big thing, it's a big thing because Facebook says it's a big thing. If you own a business page, do all your selling and offering of your services there. Do not do it on your personal page. If you do it on your personal page and somebody complains or Facebook finds out that you've been offering your services and selling your stuff on your personal profile, they can and will close your account. All right, don't advertise what you do and use it as a sales page for your personal profile. Instead, what you can do is to say, as you all know, I am an expert at this, or I know a lot about this. I give a lot of valuable information on my business page, and I think it would really help you out. Please visit that page and like it, and you can gather a whole bunch of great content. That is okay to do. Advertise your business page on your personal profile is okay. So what does work? How can we really use social media to our benefit? Well, the first thing is, I have to make a few assumptions here. Just out of curiosity, how many of you actually have a business page on Facebook? Okay, a number of you, excellent, perfect. For those who don't worry about it. At the very end of this presentation, I'm going to give you a resource where you can go to set up your business page. It's a step-by-step process, so you can set up your business page and continue on about this process we're going to talk about shortly. So first thing is, you have to have a Facebook page. Second thing, we all don't have deep pockets. We don't have hundreds, if not thousands of dollars a month to spend on advertising to hope we reach the right person so that they buy from us. I'm going to show you how you can do that for as little as $30 a month, so a dollar a day. You don't have time to do all the research to find all this content that is not about you. Time is valuable. You don't have hours a day to do this. I'm going to show you how to find it, how to do that research once and never have to do it again. And you know some popular keywords that people use in search engines to find things that you do or issues that you solve. All right, so we want to write down a few of those keywords. One could be, you know, migraines, back pain, things like that. Another good keyword, nature sunshine. You want to keep up to date with what nature sunshine is doing. So, introducing the super duper, semi-automated content curation and posting at the best possible time system. It's a horrible name. I couldn't think of what to call it, but that's what I'm going to call it for now because that's exactly what it does. The whole purpose of this is to solve that 90% problem of people always talking about themselves. We're going to start talking about everything else in our industry, and that's what we're going to do in this process here. So here it is. That is the process I use, and I constantly teach to a lot of people to use on their Facebook pages. The exact same process we use to do the Direct Selling Association's marketing campaigns. To explain this, I'm going to start right to left, just to tell you a little bit about the tools. As you can see, the heart and soul of the entire process is used by one application, and that is Buffer. Buffer is a fantastic application. You can find that at buffer.com, by the way. Buffer, what it really does is it queues up content. So you funnel a ton of content, a ton of posts into Buffer, and it stores it all. But where the real power comes out of Buffer is its scheduling ability. It can schedule posts to go out at certain times on certain days. So the next question is, well, how do I know what the best time to post an update on? On what day? I don't know that. Well, that's where we're going to use Facebook Insights. Facebook Insights will tell you that. Facebook will say on Monday at 1 p.m. is the best time to post because that's when majority of your people are on. Then on Tuesday, it's at 9 a.m. and then again at 4 p.m. And on Wednesday, it's at 3 p.m., and so on and so forth. You're going to take that information, and you're going to put it into Buffer. So now, what Buffer is going to do is take all those posts and send it out at those exact times so you can ensure that you are reaching as many eyeballs as possible with your message. So that is Buffer. The great thing about Buffer is they offer three different plans. The first one, you probably don't need, which is its business plan. It's $50 a month. It does a lot more than you need it to. You don't need that plan. Two other plans, the individual plan and what they call the awesome plan. I suggest you get the awesome plan. It is $10 a month, but it does exactly what it is we need to do. You can use the individual plan, which is free. So if you want to test it out, there is a free version that they have. The difference between the two is the individual plan only allows you to have 5 profiles on there, so that can be 5 different networks. We're only worried about one, Facebook. The awesome plan has 10. But the big difference between the two is with the individual profile or with the individual account, you can only have one time to send out your posts. And I'm guessing that your fans are not always going to be on Facebook at the exact same time on each day. That's where the awesome plan comes in handy, because it allows you to schedule as many posts as you want. It will also allow you to pick the specific days and specific times. So that's why I suggest to use the awesome plan. Everyone understand what Buffer does? Yes? All right. Feedly. Feedly is another application that's very handy. It is, if you remember that video, curation was one of the 4 C's. Feely is a curating software. What it does is it takes a plethora of websites, and I'm assuming that most of you probably use the websites, the different internet websites out there, to gather some information. It could be Nature Sunshine's blog, it could be WebMD, a bunch of other different sites. Instead of visiting those sites each and every day, and if you have 10 or 15 or 20, that can add up to time. Because you don't want to be visiting those 20 sites every single day, because that's going to eat up time. That's going to spend hours and hours a day just trying to visit sites to find content to post. So instead, what Feely does is it takes those websites and it pulls it into its application, and it tells you which posts, which articles are brand new. As soon as you click on it and you deem it, that's not important, it hides it. You don't have to see it anymore. So think about the efficiency now. You only have one website to visit to see all this new information. So instead of you having to seek out the information gets sent to you. You save a ton of time with Feely, and it's free. Feely is FEEDLY.com. Email, nothing special here. This is just your email software that you use, whether it be Outlook, Lotus, Gmail, Yahoo, Hotmail, doesn't matter. We're going to be using our email system to do part of this process. And Post Planner. Post Planner is not a necessity, but it is a huge advantage, and it'll save you a ton of time. And it'll create an immense amount of engagement if you decide to use it. Yes, it is $7 a month. I'll tell you a little trick. If you visit postplanner.com for the very first time, and you take your mouse and you scroll up as if you were going to close your browser, they have what's known as an exit pop-up. It determines when you're about to exit their page, and it'll pop up a message saying, hey, don't leave. Instead of paying $7 a month, how about you pay $5? You can save $2. Why not, right? So it's $5 a month now for you. Anyhow, what PostPlanner does is they have three main categories that's going to be very useful for you. Number one is going to be status ideas. All right? Status ideas is an area that you can go to that you don't have to think about what to post to create engagement. They'll have something like, if you know Christmas is coming up, and you can't think of an engaging post to put up for the holidays, it'll say, what are you guys doing on the holidays? Is it blank, blank, or blank? And it creates engagement. It gives you ideas so you don't have to think about it. It does the work for you. You copy and paste it into Buffer, it does it all for you. Viral photos works really, really well. It is a huge collection. It scours the entire internet and looks for photos that have gone viral. And it gives them to you and say, these are all the photos that have gone viral. If you want, you can post that onto your Facebook business page as well. And the other one is engaging articles. Engaging articles are articles that people have liked, shared numerous times because there is a lot of interest for it. It's also categorized. So if you just want top news, you can go to top news. If you want something about social media, you can do that. If you want something about health, you can go there too. Post Planner is absolutely a fantastic system to use so that you don't have to do a lot of the legwork. It will do it for you. The best part about Post Planner, it comes with a popularity scale. It will tell you which article, which status update, which photo will work best for you. It's incredibly handy. Actually, yes? Oh, Post Planner. Yeah, actually, let's see. Can we get the slideshow up on the presentation? There you go. Postplanner.com. So at the very bottom there, at the very bottom you'll see the backwards P almost. Postplanner.com. Sorry, I thought the presentation was up there. Yeah, so go to postplanner.com. It's very handy. They do offer a monthly fee or a monthly service so you can cancel if you need to or if you don't find it being useful. But I highly suggest you use it. So now that I've kind of explained, Viral photos, where are they? Viral photos are pictures that are on the internet that you see a lot of people have liked, like a million people have liked and 700,000 people have shared, like it's gone viral all over Facebook and Twitter. So they will give you those photos and they'll say, this photo has gone well. To give you an example, on the DSA, if you wanna know how this whole system works, go to facebook.com/DSA Canada. Like that page and you'll start seeing all the stuff we do. Share it if you want. One of them that I highly suggest you share is one we just did last week, which has Tony Robbins as a picture on it, and his he's doing a meditation on the beach, and it has his saying on it. I couldn't believe how viral it went on our page. We only have about 3,500 likes on the DSA Canada page, which is a lot. But it reached over 10,000 people. It got shared over 127 times. It got liked, I don't even know how many. But it went viral on our page. And that was because we used Post Planner to figure what picture would really work on our page. So I hope I kind of more or less told you what tools to use and why they're useful. Does everyone more or less understand? Hopefully, yes, perfect. Okay, so let's actually go through the system, start to finish. First things first, let's look at a couple of sites that we know. Can a few people just kind of scream out a few websites that they visit to find out information? Upworthy, okay. Upworthy, another one? WebMD, is that? Yes, no. Another one, Nature Sunshine, maybe another one. You want to create a collection of all these different websites that you commonly visit. Because it'll be the last time you're going to have to do this. Because you're going to put all these websites into Feedly. So start creating a whole pile of all these websites. Put them into a word processor, Notepad, Excel, Microsoft Word, whatever, doesn't matter. But start collecting all these. Because the next step we're going to go is we're going to use keywords. Do we have the presentation still up? Let's just keep the presentation still up just for a bit. Keywords. Keywords 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come up with keywords that people would typically put into Google to find out solutions to their ailments. So I have back issues, or I have an ankle injury, or I have migraines, stuff like that. You want to start thinking along those lines. What keywords would people use in Google to find solutions? That's what people are interested in, okay? What you're going to do then is you're going to take those keywords, you're going to put them into Google, and you're going to click search. On there, you're going to find an entire list of websites that you can go visit. If you want to take it a step further, here's a sneaky little trick that we do. At the very top of Google, when you click search and it comes up with an entire list of websites, there's categories that you can filter out. At the very top, the very first one's web. The next one is maps. Next one, I believe, is news. And then they have images and so on and so forth. The one you're interested in is news. Click on that news category. The only results you're going to see now are news articles from news sites. Start going through those news sites because they're going to constantly post interesting articles that your customers are going to be interested in. All right? Click on a link. Do some research, read over a couple of their posts. If you find that you have some valuable information, take that link and put it right in your word processor along with all the other websites that you already know about. You're going to do this maybe a few times, depending on how many keywords you have. Make sense so far? Yes? Mm-hmm. Yes? Yes. Yes. So the question was, to go over the process again, you take a keyword, your list of keywords, you take one of them, you put it into Google, you click search, it comes out with a result. You want to filter those results to only show news websites, because you know that they're going to be high quality. So at the very top, right below the search text area, there is the word news. Click on that word. It filters everything out and only shows you news sites. All right? Perfect. So we're going to do that a few times. Once we have all those websites that we want, and you'll probably come up with about 15 or 20 or 30 different sites, you can imagine how long that's going to take you to visit each site every day. You can be spending hours doing this. Instead, we're going to put that into Feedly. Because now Feedly allows us to go just to them and read all the articles in one area. So when you sign up with Feedly, you're going to see in the top right-hand corner another search bar. You take those websites that you just found, that list that you just found, so 15 or 20 different sites. You're going to take each link and you're going to paste it in the search bar. Feedly will go to that site and pull all the information down. If you really want, you can take it a step further and categorize it. So if you know the 3 out of the 15 sites that you found have to do with health, you can give it a health category. The other 5 sites might be about fitness. Make that category. The other next sites could be about nutrition. You can filter out and categorize it under nutrition. So now, again, you go to Feedly, you read all the latest updates. As soon as you find an article that you like, you click it. It opens up in its own internal browser. And because you already signed up with Buffer, it comes with a nice little Buffer icon in Feedly. You click that Buffer icon, it automatically puts it in queue, and you already know that that valuable content that you found is going to reach as many people as possible, thanks to Buffer Schedule. Does everyone understand the flow? Yes? Perfect. All right, emails. How do we use that in the system? Well, we use 2 sites, TalkWalker Alerts and Google Alerts. How many of you have used either or, Google Alerts or TalkWalker Alerts? Okay, perfect, a couple of you have. All right, for those who haven't, TalkWalker Alerts and Google Alerts is a fantastic system. It alerts you when that keyword is found. And these are new articles. These aren't articles that it already knows about. These are brand new articles that just came out that Google has found or TalkWalker Alerts has found. It will send you an email per keyword of all those sites that it found. So think about the power of this. If within 24 hours, Google knows about this brand new article that came out on WebMD or Upworthy, and you know about it, and you send it out to your customers, all of a sudden, they're going to see the date and go, wow, that was just posted like 18 hours ago. This person is already in the know. They know this information. They know where to get this information. And it's now. It's quite powerful stuff. So again, you can use both, or you can use either or. I'm not suggesting that you use both, because you'll get a lot of emails, and you don't want that. You kind of want to pick maybe the top 3 to 5 keywords and use Google Alerts or TalkWalker Alerts for that. And again, Post Planner, I'm going to go back to that, because they do also have an alerting system that's quite similar to TalkWalker Alerts or Google Alerts. I kind of have a love-hate relationship with that part of that of Post Planner, because they don't have a database as robust as Google, so they don't know of as many sites. So you won't find as much information. But what I love about it is, as I said before, it will rank those sites in terms of popularity. Which of those sites that it's listed has been shared a bunch of times, has been liked, has been commented on. And so you can pick out those articles and say, yep, I'm going to send that one off to my Facebook. All right. So that is the system that we use. Yes? Sorry? To create Google Alerts? Okay, to create Google Alerts, it's a great question, actually. Sorry, I did skip over that. To create Google Alerts, go to google.com/alerts. All right? If you want to go to TalkWalker Alerts, go to talkwalkeralerts.com. And with Google, if you have a Gmail account or if you have an account with Google, you don't have to create another Google account. You just use the existing one that you already have. All right? Any other questions about the system? I want to make sure that everyone gets this because it is very powerful. Yes? Great question. Question was, I'm going to reiterate it. Question is, how is the information that we're posting relevant to my business? How is that going to generate sales? Well, if you think about it, what you're trying to do here is build credibility, build your expertise, and you want people to start paying attention to you. If you constantly are posting stuff about yourself and your success and all the services and products you offer, people are going to be skipping over that. You want to engage with people. When you're at a party, for example, you want to be talking to people not only just about what you do. You want to be talking about other things that are relevant to them, that engage them in a conversation. You all have your specialties and expertise and what you can help people with. For example, yesterday with the Clean Start. All right? With Clean Start, it helps you clean your colon, which is great. So people who are usually coming to you are wanting to take care of themselves. They're interested in health. So what else is relevant to that? Well, if I'm interested in my own health, I'm probably going to be interested in fitness too, because I like to stay in shape. And from there, I also want to eat well. So nutrition also is very important to me. So if you start giving them that information, saying, yes, I can help you with your colon, but you know what? It all starts with good health, by eating well, by working out, taking these supplements, so on and so forth. Does that kind of more or less answer your question? Because you don't always want to be selling just your product. You want to be selling also a knowledge base so that people automatically know, going, you know what? Yes, I do only have this issue, but I also have back pain. I also have migraine issues too. And you know, I remember you posted something earlier on Facebook about how to solve migraine issues. You know, I'm going to come back to you, and I want to ask you, how do I solve migraine issues? So now you start talking about everything else too, and that becomes important to them. Are you starting to get the idea of how that kind of fits in? More or less. Mm-hmm. Great point. The other point was, and this is something you need to be aware of, and I should have mentioned this as well. Be careful which sites you're posting, you know, you're putting up on Facebook. You don't want to be sending people to your competition. You want to be sending them to informational sites. All right. When you create content, you're creating it on your Facebook page. Facebook is great for exposure. That's where you build your exposure. So by constantly updating your page at least once a day, that's going to start appearing in their feed. The more that they see you, the more exposure you get, the more you stay front of mind over your competition. All right? You're not going to be sending them to your competition, but you're going to be sending them to informational sites that they can say, oh, yes, that's how I can solve my migraine problem. Or, you know what, I love this nutrition tip. I can start eating a little bit healthier. Oh, and look at that, Nature Sunshine just came out with something that I can take to increase my metabolism. Oh, that's brilliant. So therefore, on your Facebook page, you can start generating that 90% not about you content. So that the other 10% of the time, you can say, guess what? Nature Sunshine just came out with this amazing new product. It's called Clean Start. Trust me, it will move you. You can do that, and people will be okay with that, because you're not always talking about yourself. We good? Any other questions? Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, you can. Yes, you can put status updates. So to go back to the slide here, Buffer allows you to, and this anything that touches your Facebook page should always go to Buffer first. Again, Buffer has the power to schedule posts to go out at the exact right time when most people are on your business page. So when you find an interesting article, you click the little Buffer icon. It will pop up a window on your screen, and it will attach that article to it. And you can say, hey, here's a great article on cleaning your colon or on nutrition. You can put your information on there. That'll appear on your business page, and then that will appear on their feed. So the more engagement you get on that article, so the more interesting it is to more people, the higher it will rank in their feed. So the more often people will see it. Yes? Yes.
Because you have a Facebook account.
Okay, so the question was, where does this buffer icon come from? Once you sign up for Buffer, it will automatically ask you, can we please add an icon to your browser? And I should have mentioned that, I do apologize, so thank you for asking. It will add a Buffer icon to your browser, regardless if you use Explorer or Safari or Chrome or what other ones, Firefox, it'll add a Buffer icon there. So anytime that you're on your browser, you can just click it and it'll automatically pop it up. Great question, thank you for asking. Any others?
I have a mic here, j'ai un micro, donc I can come to you and you can ask your question. Vous pouvez demander votre question, je vais venir à vous.
No? All right. So what's involved in this? Yes, I understand it's a kind of a complex system, and I do apologize if some eyes are glazing over. It is a little bit complicated, but I try to make it as easy as possible. And it will take you about 1 to 3 hours to set up. But remember, you're only having to do this once. And you'll never have to do it again, because you're never going to have to go into Google and search for keywords. You're never going to have to visit all these 50 different sites, because it's all pulled in for you. So if you do it once and you set up once, you'll never have to do it again. You just have to visit these sites once a week. Because it ultimately will only take you 15 to 20 minutes a week to post content for that entire week. If you want, for the DSA page, we have Motivational Mondays. Motivational Mondays have been queued up in our buffer up until February 2016. That's how many posts we have in there that we don't have to worry about every Monday posting a motivational little meme. It's a fantastic application. It saves a lot of time. Post Planner, again, it's not a necessity, but it is a hugely added bonus. Yes?
So, if you have it all scheduled, are you actually going to put a comment?
Like, I've heard that it's beneficial when you're putting up or sharing an article that you actually comment on it. So if you haven't seen the article that's coming out in December because it hasn't been posted yet, how are you going to comment if you've got this already scheduled till February?
Well, what you'll do is that article that you do see, that you when you click on that icon, it will automatically tag that article in. All right, it already showcased that article at the bottom. Up above, there's a little text box where you enter in your information. So you can say, hey, I just read this great article. I suggest you read it too, and I'd love to hear your opinions on it. Remember, when you put a status update, don't just write something. Ask for engagement. It's social. So yes, you can, for regardless if it's a video, an article, a photo, or just even a plain text update, you can always add more to it. You can always add your own verbiage to it.
So are you going to add your own verbiage now, or will you add it closer to like December or February when that article is coming out?
No, you add it as soon as you click that buffer icon, you add it right then and there. And then if you want it to be scheduled that far in advance, it will post whatever the content you put in on October 22nd. It will take that and it will post it in December.
We've got our list of our keywords and we've got our list of the stuff that's coming into our feed. And then we're now going to take those and schedule those. Are we going to try and keep some of it up to date as well? So like something that's pertinent today is going to get posted today or in a couple of days? Or are you going to have it go into your feed in 3 months?
Great question. That is going to be up to you to decide, and let me clarify that. You can, within Buffer, if you determine that this article is not time sensitive, whether you post it today or whether you post it 3 months from now, it's not going to make that big of a difference. All right, so you can schedule that in December. However, if there is something that is very time sensitive, you can say, I want to make sure that this post goes out on this specific day. All right, or if it's something that just got posted yesterday and you want to send it out today, you can send it out today, and it will take all the other queued posts and move it down to make room for that new one. You determine what posts go out when. Does that make sense? Excellent. All right. So again, Buffer handles all your posting. Nothing should appear on your Facebook page unless it goes through Buffer first, because it will schedule to make sure that all posts go at the exact right time so that the most eyeballs will see it. And make sure you're always adjusting the time schedule. So go every Monday morning when you're just sipping your coffee, go to your Facebook business page, click on Insights, go to the area where it shows you when people are on your page, and make sure you do those slight adjustments in Buffer just to make sure you're always keeping up with people that are on your site, because it does change slightly. Yes? The best times to post on Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus? Yeah, that's really going to depend on a variety of factors. I'll be honest with you. I've seen it vary dramatically. For the interest of the presentation, to kind of keep it within the 3 minutes I have left, Facebook does have your insights, and that will determine when you should post. Everyone's going to be different. Even the person sitting next to you could have a completely different schedule, because their customers are going to be different from your customers. So therefore, their times that they're on Facebook are going to be different from yours, and that's also applicable to Pinterest and Google. I will tell you this, Thursdays and Fridays are always the best times to post a lot of information. Why? The less people want to be at work, the more they're going to be on Facebook. And it's true. All right, so let's kick it up a notch here. Facebook ads. Facebook ads is brilliant. I love Facebook ads. It really gets a ton of people to like your page. And these aren't just general people. These are very targeted people. Hyper, what I call hyper-specific targeting. I could say, for whatever reason, I can say, standing right here, I want to reach people within a 1 kilometer radius of me right now. But I also want to focus on people that are male and female, between the ages of 20 and 23, that have red hair and a golden retriever. You can get that specific with Facebook ads. So why is that important to you? Well, you can reach your targeted audience. And I'm going to show you how you can do that in just a sec. It's very cost effective. The average price for a like for you will probably end up being around 20 to 25 cents. And that, of course, that depends on whether you're in a metropolitan area or you're in out in the country. But it is very cost effective to get a like on your page. It is also the fastest way to get targeted likes, because you're reaching people right away. And it's incredibly simple to use. So I don't want to scare you away saying, oh, Facebook, I don't want to even touch Facebook ads. It scares me. It's not. Don't worry. Facebook made it very easy to use. It's to their benefit, because you're paying them. They want your money. So the easier that they can make it, the more likeliness you're going to pay them to have an ad. So how do we go about this? Well, I'm not going to go through exactly the step-by-step how to launch an ad, because, again, Facebook makes it very simple to do. But if you go to facebook.com/ads/manager, that's where you'll start. A few areas that you do want to focus on, first one being location. You want to make sure that you choose your city. And if you're in a metropolitan area and you can't service everybody in that area, draw a radius around it and say, I want to reach people within a 10-kilometer radius or a 5-kilometer radius. You can break it down by age and gender as well. So take a look at your customers. Who are your most popular customers? Who are the top 20% of your customers that generate 80% of your business? Those are the people you want to start reaching. Interests. As I mentioned to you before, people who are seeing you are also interested in health, wellness, nutrition, fitness. You can even narrow it down to say yoga, Pilates, what have you. So start focusing on what interests you think your customers have, aside from just being within your industry. Connections, very important here. Make sure that when you're advertising, that you don't already advertise to people that have already liked your page. So exclude those people. Exclude people that have already liked your page because they already have liked your page. You don't want to beat them over the head to say, like my page, it is not gonna work. So exclude those people. And set your daily budget for $1. You will get a huge result from $1 a day. Think about it. If you're spending 20 cents per like, and Facebook will ensure that you reach your $1, that's 5 likes a day. Times 30, that's 150 likes in 1 month you can get. And these are targeted people. These aren't just general public. These are targeted people that you determined who they should be. So hopefully that makes some sense. So I'm gonna give you some secret hints because I've done this a few hundred times. Focus on in-feed ads. Now what are in-feed ads? Well, when you're looking through your timeline, you're gonna notice that you'll have a post from your sister, a post from your brother, a post from your son, and then all of a sudden, boom, there's an ad. That's what we're talking about. If you're on a desktop, whether it be PC or Mac, you notice ads on the right-hand side, we don't care about that. My tests have shown that those don't work for what we call like campaigns. So those don't work for people who we wanna reach to like our page. So focus on in-feed ads. When you launch your campaign, take a look at the statistics 24 hours, 48 hours, 72 hours afterwards. What you're gonna notice is something amazing. You're gonna notice that either mobile or desktop will outperform one another. For us, majority of the times, it's mobile. So therefore, we will deactivate the ads from showing on desktops, whether it be PC or Mac. We will only want to show these ads on mobile devices. You might as well spend the money where it's going to suit you best. And that's probably going to be mobile. It may be different from you, but our tests have shown otherwise. Native video. Native video is working exceptionally well. If you don't care to be on camera, that's fine. But if you do have a mobile device, instead of sending a text update, take a selfie and record it. Do a little 5-10 second little clip and post it directly to buffer it straight into Facebook. You will be amazed at how well video does right now on Facebook. So try it out. Fortunately, my time was up about 5 minutes ago, so I do apologize, but I hope I gave you a lot of information. The 10x10 formula is something, it's actually gonna be part of the resource that I'm gonna give you in just a sec. So I'm not gonna go through that because we've already explained it, but it is another great way to create engagement on your Facebook page. On your tables in that handout, there are schedules and timetables. Keep that by your computer. It's very handy to have, all right? The schedules, you'll see on there Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and beside each one, there are themes. We call them theme days. So motivational Mondays, throwback Thursdays, way back Wednesdays, funny Fridays. All right, those work well. So just a little bit of a hint, try that out. Timetables, also good to have. That's where we've posted a bunch of different events that or holidays that happen throughout the year. Also good to kind of have in the back of your mind so you can maybe start thinking about, hey, Christmas is coming up. Maybe I want to throw out a post saying, hey, the holidays are coming. What are you doing? Creates engagement. And it's time sensitive as well. Have a repository of information. I gave you a few different sites here. Freeimages.com, great for posting free images if you want. Icon Finder, it's great if you want to find an icon that represents a particular product, such as Twitter, Google, or if you want to find an emoticon, which is the happy face or the frowny face, that kind of stuff. Inspirational and motivational quotes, very, very, very useful. Instead of you having to think of an inspirational quote or a motivational quote, it's already done the legwork for you. Copy, paste in a buffer, it works well. So I did tell you that, there is something to remember here. If you don't remember anything at all, this is what I want to hit home. Read and review past posts. Make sure that you're liking people's comments, you're engaging with them, you're commenting back. Never, ever, ever, ever advertise your business and sell your products on your personal profile. Make sure that you're telling people, go to my business page. You don't want your account to be shut down. Add more pictures and stop talking about you. Use that process I showed you. And create a schedule and keep it current. And have fun, but maintain it. So I did tell you that there's gonna be a resource that we had. And for the people that are just starting off with Facebook and don't really understand, we do have a social caterpillar program for $9.95 that will help you kind of get started on Facebook and social media. For those that are a little bit more savvy with social media, you'll want to look at the $29.95 package a month, because we give you access to everything, anywhere from tutorials to resource centers, motivational quotes. We have a plethora of them. Marketing campaigns, everything you can think of is in that pile. And that is the one I highly suggest you use. Now, I did say that I was going to end this with a big gift. Now, I think this really deserves a huge round of applause after I announce it, because I've been working with Nature Sunshine for the last little while on this. And they said, you know what, Matt? We really want you to do something amazing. We love our people, and we want to blow them away. So we want to give them a substantial discount. I said, fine, I'm all open to that. Come back to me with an idea, and they did. And wow, was I blown away. So you know how much you are going to have to pay for this? And this is the $29.95 package to get everything? Nothing. They are paying for you to do it. All right? Go to ns.d-soulmedia.com. You will have complete full access to our system for free. All right, so that includes Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Pinterest, YouTube, and yes, we are going to be doing Instagram very shortly. I have my social media article writer doing all that right now. Marketing ideas programs, the 10x10 is in there, and the resource center is in there as well. Yes. Sorry, I can't really hear you. Can we get it? Is it in French? We are going to be doing that in French. That is one of the topics we are talking about. Right now, it is in English. We are looking to convert all that information. There's a plethora of information, so please give us some time. We are going to translate everything into French. No, we will not be using Google Translate. All right? I don't like Google Translate. I have a French-speaking individual that will be doing all the translation for you. Yes? Yes. Great question. The question is, after you run your ad and they've liked your page, do you have to add them as a friend to interact with them? The answer is no, you don't. You interact with them on your page. You can click on their profile and start a chat with them on your business page. But you usually want to have them start the communication with you first. Because some people are a little hesitant if you start the communication first, because they think that you're going to start selling them and pushing your stuff on them, okay? So here's what I'm going to do, because I have a feeling that that whole process that we spent a good 20 minutes on, I see, give me 1 second, probably confused a few people. How advantageous would it be if I actually did a step-by-step video tutorial going from start to finish? Would that help you all out? I will do that. I will book my next week off to make sure I get you that. Give me some time. I will ensure that that goes up on your training portal. Yes, question over here. How long is the promotion for? As long as you want it to be on. It will be, right now, we are going to be doing a little test beta up until the end of December, I believe, and then we'll be talking about continuing it on, and that's when I hope to get everything in French translated for you. Yes? Yes, that's what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to be really kind of spending a lot of time on the individual programs as well, aside from the entire process. But that process should cover that as well. How to get onto Buffer, where to find it, and all that stuff. Anything else? No? Perfect. All right, sorry for taking time, but Thank you very much.
Let's hear for Matthew Murchie up here. Matthew, can we have a social media moment with you right now? You know what? I promised our human NSP some products. Where are my three volunteers that came up here? NSP, come back up here. We're going to take a selfie here with Matthew Murchie, and I got some products for you guys. So those three volunteers that were up here earlier, come on up here. Let's implement right now what Matthew told us about, and let's get noisy on social media here. Where's those three? Here they are. One, two, and three. All right. Now, we did the human NSP. Can you guys do that again? But now we need a photographer. Who's got a selfie cell phone? Who could take a picture for us? One more volunteer. Okay, come on. First one up. Okay, come right up here. Let's get a picture here with Matthew doing the NSP, and you can hold right here a bottle of this. We got to get a product out here. This is called chlorophyll. All right, here we go. The NSP, everyone, say cheese. Yes, awesome. Well, you guys rock. We have the bottle of NSP's chlorophyll for each of you right here. And then Matthew Murchie, I got some more products backstage for you. How's that? Give it up for Mr. Social Media right here. Yes. Thank you, everybody. Woo!